Hi, I'm Alyssa from the Jane Support Team. This video is going to take a look at Jane Payments. So we'll take a look here at how you can add a credit card on file for a patient, how to process a payment using Jane Payments, and we'll also take a look at how you can send off a pay balance email. So starting from the main schedule, I'll first show you how you can add a credit card on file for a patient. You can do this in a few different areas in Jane. The first spot would be inside the appointment panel. So I'm just using Elvis as my example here, and looking under the booking info section, you can see if there is a valid credit card on file just underneath the patient email. So here I can see that there's no credit card on file. If I'd like to add one, you can just click right onto the text and it's going to open up a page that will let you start entering the credit card number in. The other area in Jane that you can add a credit card is right within the patient profile. So if I just head into the patient profile for Elvis and go into the billing section, you can head over to the credit cards tab. And this area, you can see any of the cards that have been saved on file for the patient, and you can also see any transaction history. If you hop over to the right, you can add a brand new credit card. So that's going to take you to the same page. If you have multiple cards on file here, you'll be able to see the card type, so if it's a Visa or a MasterCard, and then you'll only be able to see the last four digits as reference. So now let's head over to the schedule. We'll take a look at how you can actually process a payment using Jane Payments. So I'm going to arrive Elvis for his visit. This is now creating an invoice, so he's owing $75 for his appointment. To collect a payment, you can start by clicking on the Pay button. This will bring you to a page to review the invoices. So any outstanding invoices for the patient will appear here. You can let Jane know how much you are collecting from the patient towards the outstanding invoice. So right away we can see the $75 that the patient is owing. If you wanted to partially pay off the invoice, say you were only collecting $50 from the patient, you can update that in this page here, and it's going to partially pay off the balance. I'm going to say that I'm receiving the full amount from the patient, so I'll say $75. Once you have decided on the amount you're collecting, you can click Next. And this is the area in Jane where you can let her know how the patient is paying. So in this section, we will first click on Add Payment Method. This will bring up a window where you can choose an existing card on file, or you can add in a brand new credit card. The section at the bottom is only for payments that have happened outside of Jane. So if you do have a debit or Visa or MasterCard option here, this section is only recording that the transaction happened. So if you are hoping to actually process payment on the credit card on file, you'll want to make sure to stay up at the top under the Jane payment section. So I'm going to click in and add a credit card here. This is the last section in Jane that you can add a credit card for the patient. Once you've entered the card details, click Save. We can now see a Visa has been saved on file. I can see the last four digits here for reference. To process the payment onto this card, you can pay with no receipt, you can pay and print a receipt, or you can pay and email a receipt. If you ever wanted to split the payment, maybe the patient is going to pay $50 by Visa and then the rest by cash, you can just use the Add Payment Method button to divide up the payments as you need to. So I have my total covered and I'm going to click Pay and Email. Great, so the receipt has now been emailed to the patient. If I'd like to see the information that I just processed, I can head into the billing area, and under credit cards, I can now see that this card is saved on file here. I can see the card number that it's ending in. If I'd like to see the transaction history, I can click View. The Payments tab is going to show you a history of the payments that you have collected by payment type. If you are working with a patient, let's say that Elvis has come in for a second visit, but this time he has forgotten his wallet. A way that you can send an invoice to a patient using Jane Payments is by heading into the patient profile, into the billing tab, and using the pay balance email. So here you can add a personal note to go alongside the email. Once you send this email off, that will allow the patient to click on a link and pay off the amount owing on the account. Okay, great. I hope that that has helped understand how to process a payment using Jane Payments. If you are looking for online booking settings and requiring a credit card online for bookings, that is found under the Settings section. And just under the Online Booking tab. So here you can find a section on prepayments and deposits where you can set a payment policy for the first visit or for each time a patient books. If you have any other questions about using Jane Payments, we're happy to help. Please feel free to reach out to the Jane support team. Have a great day.